beautiful souls. Move this just a bit. Much better. Hello, beautiful souls. I am so excited and grateful to have each of you here today. My name is Christina, also known as the Rainbow Warrior here on YouTube. I'm a psychic medium and Reiki practitioner, teacher, working out of the Virginia area. And I'm excited about today's session. Always excited about our sessions, but I'm stoked about this one. So today's theme is going to be removing energetic projections. Removing energetic projections. So what do I mean by that? What are energetic projections? So the way I like to think about it, energetic projections are very similar to evil eye type projections in terms of energy. Oftentimes when someone else other than ourselves obviously is so hyper focused on us, whether it be because we've experienced falling out with this person, whether it be because it's a relationship that has just ended with this person, perhaps it's a coworker that we don't get along with very well, whatever the case may be, I've found in my own Reiki practice that I would start seeing energetic projections in my client's auric field as I would work. And before I go any further, I hope this isn't too spooky or scary sounding to others. It's not my intention. Just want to bring awareness to this particular thing. But energetic projections seem to be sent to us from other people. Whether it be they're jealous of us, or whether it be just they're replaying that loop, excuse me, they're replaying that loop of their perception of us in their head. And it could be completely inaccurate, but the energy of that has to go somewhere, and usually it comes straight to us. That's why I usually really emphasize with my students how important auric field protection, grounding, and clearing is each day. Because besides just going out into, you know, our everyday world where we can very easily pick up on projection type of energy, I've most noticed it when my client has gone through either some sort of falling out, has ended some sort of relationship with someone, or it's someone that is very hyper-focused on them, and oftentimes they're not even aware of it. So what we're going to be working on is clearing these energetic projections today, removing these energetic projections. So any energetic projection that I see within your auric field, I'm going to pluck and remove, okay? This can be the energy of jealousy. Oftentimes it is the energy of jealousy, quite often. But other times it can just be someone's dislike for us. That energy of dislike can be sent to us, and then we often start picking up on it by, say for instance, out of the blue, you start experiencing issues with your self-esteem, whereas before you felt very confident in who you were, never experienced any issues with your self-esteem, and suddenly, all of a sudden, you feel like the walls are caving in on you. You start questioning everything you do, overthinking every action, overthinking every word that you speak. And really, it's not even energy that is from you. It's someone else's gunk that they've sent to you, right? So that's what we're going to focus on. Releasing that energy that isn't ours, that's been projected to us. And we're going to refill it with supportive, empowering, supportive energy. Let's get started. Sorry for the long intro. I want to try and explain these things as best as I can. With Mercury being a retrograde, I often stumble over my words and have a hard time articulating the things I want to say. So which that's the smokeless juniper sage mist. And I'm just gonna set the intention that this spray help loosen up these projections within our work field. Start to kind of uproot them, if you will. Oftentimes as well, these projections little hooks at the end of them, which makes it difficult to just be able to pluck them out. You have to work a little bit harder. Okay. So I'm gonna spray in the four corners of your aura, and then I'm going to go to your back and spray all along the back of your head, along the back of your neck, and the back of your shoulders. I often see projection energy around the back of your head. And along the back of your head, neck, and shoulders, right? So along the back of your head. Back of your neck. Along the back of your shoulders. Left side of the back of your shoulders. Middle of your shoulders. Thank you. this to tell some of you. Some of you might feel like some very light tingles on your skin as I work. And some of you might even feel like some goosebumps as I work as well. So just wanted to give you the heads up on that. I didn't want to scare you, okay? So starting above your head.
Using my wand.
setting the intention to channel Reiki energy through this wand as I work, but I'm just going to begin drawing the balance symbol, which to many of you looks like the infinity symbol. But I'm going to be drawing that balance symbol starting with your left hip. Focusing on balancing this channel, this pathway of energy for your greatest and highest good. Also down to the right, setting the intention on channeling Reiki energy and balancing energy into this channel, this pathway of energy, and all for your greatest and highest good. Much better. because it's such a protective stone, such a purifying stone, really pushes that negative energy out, almost like a magnet being pushed against an opposing pole almost. So what I want to do is I want to use these to very lightly sever those projection energies and sever those hooks that are still remaining within your auric field. I only see a few of them still, but just for safe measure, I'm going to go all around your auric field, just like this. Okay, all right. We're just setting the intention that any of this projection energy untether itself from your workspace, unhook itself from your workspace as I move about with these obsidian urns. All right, so we're starting above your head. Using this obsidian arrowhead, it's almost like sometimes that projection energy will almost look like somebody unplugged a machine from the plug almost. It's almost like it just goes dead when it encounters certain type of energy, so. Chest. Session today. I send each of you so much love and appreciation whenever and wherever.